What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to episode 2 of Northern Valley. We're back here in Northern Valley, obviously, and we're gonna go ahead and start a little village area on the map. But before we get into that, I want to go ahead and welcome all of the new subscribers to my channel. Since the last episode, or the first episode of this went up, my channel has gained about 70 subscribers, which is amazing. I am so happy that all you can join me and join us. And yeah, you guys went crazy in the comments in the last episode, and we're going to get to some of that stuff too. But yeah, I just keep up the good work, and I hope you guys enjoy the series, and we're just going to build this city as best we can, and with your help, I know it's going to be amazing. So let's go ahead and jump into the episode. What I did first was go ahead and take out a bunch of the highways and one of the rail lines, and actually I completely forgot to put the rail line back in at the end of this, so we're going to have to work around that. I'm not sure, I might wind that up around like all of the mountains and just make it some weird railroad all the way up through everything and around the whole city. It could be kind of interesting. We'll kind of check out and see how that goes when we get to it. But the first thing, well, in the last episode, I had talked a little bit about making this highway a turnpike type thing, a toll road, if you will. And I went ahead and I went with that idea. I think it's a really cool idea because there's only one highway connection going through this city. Well, I guess technically there's two points where cars spawn and despawn in here, but yeah, there's only one highway running through it, so I was like, that makes sense that it would be a toll road, you know? It'd be a turnpike through the area, and so we're gonna do that. I'm only gonna have maybe two, maybe three exits off of this highway, and then we're gonna set up our own, like, inner city highway connection throughout the area. It's gonna be kinda interesting. I can't wait to see how it turns out, actually. It's gonna be kinda interesting, like I said. But yeah, so the first thing I did was go ahead and I had to make a custom interchange to get everybody off of this turnpike and into the village that we create in this episode. So yeah, interchanges are the most difficult thing to do in this game. I might be safe in saying that, I'm not really sure. But yeah, to get something to look really, really nice takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of, I guess, eye, like design eye, if you can say that, if you know what I mean. Like, you have to have a good eye for it. And I think I do. And I think I've noticed over playing this game for so long that the most important thing is that everything is smooth. All of the angles are smooth, which was kind of a pain for me because you have to make sure the left and right is smooth, but you also have to make sure that the up and down is smooth, and you only have like two dimensions to play with, because as soon as you try to move the camera, the whole point of which the highway is going down changes, so it's a little finicky, but we definitely got it right. It looks really cool, and it actually works, which is always a good thing. And by say works, I mean the roads work together. The toll booths don't actually do anything, they're just there for looks. But we can always imagine, right? It would be kind of nice if the toll roads were kind of implemented into the game and you could get, I think SimCity back in the day had that. You could actually put toll roads up on your highways and it would generate revenue for your city, which is kind of cool. But yeah, we don't have that just yet. Maybe in a future DLC pack, guys, maybe? Anyway, if you're seeing the map and it looks a little different than the last episode, it's because I've gone ahead and I've changed the theme of the map, and I've also played a little bit with the color correction, I believe. So before we just had a normal theme, it was the Boreal theme, and now we have the realistic temperate theme on. And if you watch Fresh Popcorn, he's using a theme, the same creator, I think he's using a different one. There's a couple different map themes that you can download and then swap out, and you have to reload the map up every time you change it, so that was kind of annoying for me because this map's taking forever to load right now because I don't have it saved on an SSD. But yeah, it takes a good 12 minutes to load, and I got in and I put the one on. I think I just put the Boreal map on, or the Boreal theme, and it looked really nice. It had the kind of like, this map reminds me of a northern type map, so like I want to say like Alaska type just because of the surroundings and the mountains, but yeah, I liked the boreal theme a lot, but the only thing that I had issue with was that the cement, you can see it changed from the original vanilla cement, just with the texture packs. The cement in the boreal realistic, it was so bright. It was way overwhelming. So I went ahead and I tried the European one, and it didn't look right with the colors. I was going for a really specific color scheme for some reason. But yeah, this one definitely catches it, and I like how it looks. So we're going to go ahead and stick with that one. If you want to download it, I've attached it into the collection that I have for this series, and that is always going to be linked in the descriptions below the like button. Hint, hint. Anyway, the subtle marketing from YouTubers has really picked up in the past few years, hasn't it? Alright, anyway, so what we're doing here in this episode is building this little village. And this village, in my mind, it has some traits of something that would be off a turnpike. But at the same time, it's kind of got an identity crisis, because there are a little bit more upscale parts of the district, and it's, I don't know, when you think of a turnpike, I think it's just because I have a buddy who lives next to a turnpike in a trailer park, but yeah, like, the surrounding areas of a turnpike, for whatever reason, have always been, like, I don't know, I don't want to say run down, it was just lower income areas, if that makes any sense, and it always seems to be cutting through areas that aren't less populated, I guess is a good way to put it. So yeah, I went through and I did a few things in the city center. I put a Walmart in, and of course the first restaurant I plopped down in this city is a Taco Bell. I can't even describe how much I love Taco Bell. But yeah, we also put a couple hotels next to the turnpike. And with the Rico mod enabled, these are going to be functioning, I believe, although this zone is not going to be zoned as tourist, so I don't know how they work. They may just be for looks at this point. But I noticed that when I searched hotels, I got all of the default hotels to pop up too, so I don't know if I plop those down, how that would work. I don't know how the Rico mod works in actuality in sometimes here, so I'm just kind of winging it. And really, we're not going to get to simulation type stuff until probably next episode, because by the end of this, we have a couple things that we need to figure out before we can really get people moved in and really start the city life, I guess is a good way to put it. Right now, we're just kind of designing the first couple zones, and it'll come to life more in the next couple episodes, hopefully. But yeah, the first episode obviously was the dam, and we got that sorted. And this episode is just putting some housing around and putting a nice little town, which you guys actually need to name. I forgot to mention that in the front of this episode. But yeah, you guys need to suggest a name for this. And we're also going to have to suggest a name for a couple things per the comments that you guys left. So stick around for that, and we'll have to go through and figure that all out. So yeah, your guys' comments were really, really good in the last episode, and we have to name the dam, and I think we're going to in the live portion of this video, so stick around for that as well. But yeah, I'm kind of hopping around everywhere here. So the electricity that came off of the dam, I figured wouldn't just run into, like, the power lines in this game, they don't have a really good ending. Like, you could just plop them next to a house and they just kind of stop. So I figured if I use the same substation asset and then have the electrical lines run into it, it's gonna look a lot better. And then we could transport, we can use that same concept and transport the electricity throughout the map, other places. So yeah, and if you ever, like, if you're ever driving down a highway and you see those big power lines that are eventually hooked up to a substation, you'll notice they always kind of travel in pairs too. So we're gonna take that concept and swing that through the rest of the series as well. So yeah, I'm just trying to take influence from things that I see around. And I was down by a river yesterday. And so I've got a couple really good ideas for what we can do with the riversides on this map, because we have so many of them, obviously. So it's gonna be kind of interesting. It's just, this game, you can take a lot from just looking around and noticing things. Like, if you ever played this game, you may have, like, been on a highway lately and notice like interchanges all of a sudden. It's the weirdest thing. Like when you go ahead and play a game, you start to notice how things work, and it's kind of cool. But yeah, so for the, not this development on the substation side, but the development across the main street, I actually went into Google Maps and I just looked at some surrounding areas, and I really took influence from just some of the local areas that I live by. So it definitely comes out a lot better. Like when you're just given a plot of land in this game and are told make some housing, you kind of don't know what to do at first, you know? And so you just kind of try to slap some stuff down and hope it comes out good. But after a while, you might be like, ah, this doesn't look good. And if you watch some of the bigger YouTubers like Flux and Strict Toaster, you'll notice some of their designs. And a lot of their designs are actually based off of real life. And so it is really good to go in and start to just like, just get an overview of Google Maps and just see like how people design roads. And if you know the basics of like road anarchy, or not anarchy, but hierarchy, you'll kind of understand what's going on. So like the main roads branch off into side main roads, and then like residential roads branch off of that. So it's all, you can really do a lot with this game. This game doesn't give you many tools in the vanilla portion of the game, but then you can utilize them and really do a lot more with it. And then you add mods on top of that, and it's really amazing. So like all of these turn lanes that I'm putting in here, those are all the network extension lanes. And so I'm starting to get the grasp of them. And actually you'll see me kind of like line up just some straight roads here. And I actually abandoned that entire idea and go ahead and do something more of like a development you would see just around. So yeah, you'll kind of see that now. So that's good. But yeah, anyway, this episode isn't so much detailing. It's more just a general design episode, I would say. But there is actually, no, there is a little bit of detailing going on in the main parts of the town, if you can call it a town. But we'll definitely get into that in the live portion of this video. But yeah, as you'll see, this development starts to take shape, and it looks really interesting from the air. And then when you start to like zone it, and then when you start to put trees down, it's when it really starts to look like somebody would move in here and call this place home. So yeah, you'll actually notice a lot of the, if you can catch it, I have the tool that can toggle the spaces on a road, so you can toggle the zoning, and it actually helps out a tremendous amount in this, I guess, episode. So yeah, any of the main roads that I'm not gonna put anything on, I just toggled those spaces off. So it actually gives you a lot more space to work with when you go ahead and plug down other zones, because the zones don't conflict then. And so you can actually build more on the roads that you wanna build more on. It's pretty interesting. But anyway, we're putting some services down. And speaking of services, like I said before, we're missing some in this city right now, and namely death care and water treatment. We have plenty of water because of the clarifiers up at the dam, but we don't have anywhere that's treating said water. So any sewage, nothing's like outflowing right now. So it's kind of an issue, but we're gonna settle that in the next episode. We're definitely gonna build like the city's waste treatment centers and all that kind of stuff. But yes, we're getting toward the end of the time-lapse portion of this video now, and we're gonna go back live here, and I'm gonna go ahead and take you guys on a tour and point out some of the stuff that we kind of maybe glanced over. And we're gonna plan a little bit more into the future of this episode or this series, and you guys are gonna have to help me name a few things. So let's go back live. Alright guys, here we are back live in Northern Valley, and we're at the dam to start, because we have named the dam, and actually a surprising amount of comments were alluding to just calling it Northern Valley Dam, which I'm fine with. I had a few comments call it Deke Dam. I'm not that much of an egomaniac. I don't really like naming things after myself. other than my YouTube channel, I guess. But yeah, in the games, I'm not really a big fan of that, though. I mean, I guess it may have a place at some point. We may do something like that. But Northern Valley Dam is good for now. And the lake, we have named Lake Villamo, I believe is how you pronounce it. Someone actually recommended that, and it was kind of cool. There's like a Finnish god or something of water or fish, and it's really like a mythology type thing. So I thought it sounded pretty cool, so we're going to go ahead and name it that. And I've actually gone ahead and created a district around it. And you'll notice it's bigger than just the lake, and that's because I had a really interesting comment that said we should put some roads and stuff up through here and then make it kind of like a camping spot, which is kind of cool. But we're gonna have to do some terraforming around it, and yes, we'll get to that eventually. So yeah, the map theme, you'll notice the sides of the cliffs are different. They look better in my opinion, except for certain areas. If you get too close, it looks a little weird, but like this little random spot right here, what is this all about? It's maybe just like randomly generated spot where there's gonna be a dark streak. I'm not exactly sure, but I don't know, not a big deal. But yeah, the sides of this mountain look way cooler now instead of that like brownish kind of texture. The waterfalls look still pretty cool, I think. I would say so. But yeah, this, you'll see that the map is kind of now going for what I think is good in terms of color correction. I've gone through a few different ones, and some of them were very green heavy. Some of them were very contrasted, very vibrant. And for whatever reason, the semi-washed out look just really suits this map. I don't want it to be super clean, but like, I don't know. For some reason, I just think of this as being like in the northern areas of maybe like in Alaska or something along those lines, but without all of the snow. So, yeah. Also, I had a really good comment and I completely forgot this, but they said define north, and I think north is going to be, it's going to, it, no. All right, yeah, it's going to be this way. This is going to be north. I've decided this. So if I actually go out here, and I go into the purchasing. So this will be north, and then this is obviously west, east, south, and then you guys can kind of direct in your comments, go nuts and say things like go north of Lake Villamo or east of Lake Villamo, that kind of stuff. It's gonna make you guys a lot more clear in how to describe things. The other thing that this person said was to name the two rivers. So if I go back to this, we have this main river with the waterfalls coming down into the bay, and then this other side river that is kind of meandering and splits off. And so you guys need to go through and actually name these two rivers. This one will be River A, this one will be River B. So River A is on the dam, River B is the one that kind of surrounds this island. And yeah, you guys can kind of name that. I hope it's not super confusing, but we'll clear it up once you guys name it. So yeah, you can notice now that all of these services, we have some issues here. A lot of these houses, like, people are sick, which is kind of weird because there is actually a hospital up here. But yeah, a lot of people are dead, and I remedied that by just putting one crematorium in here. I'm actually not going to keep that there, I don't think. We're going to probably set up a graveyard somewhere. I'm not really sure where just yet, but yeah. So at the really early set of this episode, I was deleting this highway and this train line, which I never relinked up. It's just kind of laying here now, kind of an issue. But like I said, I'm thinking that I'm just going to take the train line and just wind it all the way around here, all the way around through here, and then maybe have a split off here and then go into the city and then connect back up back here somewhere. Yeah, I don't know who designed this map, but it's a really good, it's an amazing map, don't get me wrong, but the highways are just kind of, I just placed, they're not very symmetric, and the train line is kind of just wandering around at points. But I mean, over here, we're not even supposed to be playing. We have the mod that lets us get up there, and to be fair, I've tried to create maps. I'm actually really bad at creating maps, but Yeah, they don't give you a lot of good tools to set highways down nice, so I'm gonna give them a benefit of a doubt. But yeah, I moved the highway back toward the little mountainside over here, and this was for purpose. We weren't really gonna put anything on this side of the highway up to a certain toll booth, I guess. But I wanted to mostly regain a lot of this on the river property here. So this is going to be a really interesting little spot. We can do a lot with maybe tourism or something along those lines. Like I said, this little city, this little area, which you guys are going to rename in the comments, hopefully. It's right now, it's currently Lafayette Park, which is not what I had in mind. So yes, you guys name that. This little area, it's not, it's like a big time city, or it's more like a big time village that is just positioned awkwardly, I think. So it's like high end housing meets like next to a major turnpike. So it's kind of grasping for some sort of identity at this point. But I think if we put like a tourism district down here, it'll give it more of a thing to be. Like right now, there's a Walmart and there's a Taco Bell. I love the Taco Bell. This is amazing. Whoever made this asset, I have to like give you a dollar to go buy a cheesy gordita crunch or something, which it's not a dollar. I know that. Sadly, I go there so much. what other fast food restaurant reinvents their menu like every other week and makes you come back to try new stuff? Nobody. But that's why we love it. And it's pretty much all the same food, but I'm going off on a tangent. Yeah, don't get me started on Taco Bell. It's, I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, this little city, if we turn this into a tourist area, this little city suddenly becomes the first stop off the turnpike for people who are vacationing in this area. So this, I think these roads will be able to handle that kind of traffic, the tourism traffic. But yeah, this will be like an area where people can come in. You know, if you've ever been on like a vacation, you have to stop at a Walmart and get some things that you forgot at home, that kind of stuff. And yes, so definitely interesting. And the other interesting part is when we get the rest of the city kind of built out over here and over here, to get over here by highway, it's the only way. The turnpike is the only way to get here. So you're going to have to spend like a quarter to get back to your house, unless you want to take the scenic highway, which is going around the dam, which is kind of cool. It's just going to be such a longer drive. And someone had recommended to put a bridge down here. I had a couple people, even on Reddit, someone said put some sort of bridge down here. And I did when I was actually making this at first. It just didn't look good. It looks so awesome right now the way it is, just open. And it doesn't look good having a bridge there. I tried it. I tried to put one like right up on the side here. And even then, I couldn't get it to look anywhere near as good as it looks now. So the bridge is not going to happen. So people are going to have to take the long way, which shouldn't be that big of a deal. And actually, we could probably put just some sort of bypass like right here. That's actually a really good idea. We'll just do like a bridge over to here. So that'll give people kind of a quicker way to go. They don't have to take the scenic route. But anyway, you'll notice the power lines here. We've gone ahead and added the path work all the way back here. Some gate work around here, and then we have houses popping up. I had tried to put a theme on. You may have seen that in the time lapse, but I had tried to put some themes or a America Suburbia type theme down here, and apparently there aren't enough level 1 houses to have that kind of stuff going. So unfortunate, but we have to stick with the vanilla for now. I may be able to tweak that. I'm not exactly sure. And yeah, but anyway, I put a little campsite down here on the river, and like I said, when you zoom in, sometimes these cliff sides can look a little frustrating, but yeah, this is a little thing that I don't think I put in the time lapse, but yeah, it's just a little path. I wanted to make it kind of secluded, so it's just like a path that maybe no one really knows about unless you're from around here, and you walk down, there's a couple people camping, there's actually a campfire down here, so at night, it'll look pretty cool, although I did turn the night cycle off for now, for whatever reason. But yeah, so there's a little area, and I figured I'd put some benches facing the river. It's actually a really cool view. You can see the waterfall, one of the waterfalls. Yeah, I guess that's kind of technically a little waterfall. But yeah, I also figured somebody would come here and start to fish into the river from here, so kind of cool. Anyway, let's get back into the high school area. So I put a couple schools down here, the elementary school and the high school, and people have been dying at the high school. And it's been, well, I guess it's not a death, that's an ambulance, so that's at least good. But people are choking on their food at the high school. It's like no one in the city has taught their children how to eat properly. But anyway, this came out fairly awesome, I think. This little set of curbs and median type things here, it looks really cool. Like, you can drive your car here, come up here and park in the back, and it kind of creates the right angle over here, but then it cuts it on a 45, so we can put these spaces on a 45. And these aren't actually lined up correctly, and it's gonna irk me, but I don't know. You guys have to give me some leeway on stuff like that. Like the I try to get fences as well, as nicely put down as possible, but like parking spaces are just a major pain to get done right. So I don't know. This Walmart, I've noticed that trucks come here and they just kind of sit right here. It's actually on fire right now, hilariously. Luckily, it's right across the street from the actual fire department, so at least they're plopping some water onto that. But yeah, this Coca-Cola truck just kind of went right here. I actually cut a road back here. I figured supply trucks, and if anybody wanted to cut to the parking lot real quick, they could come back here. And I thought I had turned the street light off here. Maybe it didn't save or something. But yeah, so trucks could come back here to get their deliveries done and come out easily. But apparently they don't do that, so that's good. Oh, garbage is a big thing too. We're gonna have to get a garbage center set up as well in the next episode. So yeah, I don't know. Oh, I guess one more little detail. Well, actually, behind this little motel, I don't remember what motel this is. It's an Ibis? Is that how you pronounce it? I know it's a foreign hotel, but I've seen like Best Western type hotels around the US like that. And speaking of Best Westerns, we actually have one here. I really like the motels, and it adds a lot to this game. So at first I had put a lot of these like big pine trees up. I don't know if those are actually pine trees, but either way, I put a line of those up, and I figured if you were a hotel like manager, you wouldn't want the only or the main road to be like obstructing, or a line of trees to obstruct the view that people getting off the turnpike have to your hotel. So I actually opted for some lighter foliage on the back, and I figure that this bigger hotel wouldn't mind if some taller trees were there because they have a big front presence, but the Best Western would want to have more of a view of the Best Western, so they actually have just some smaller trees lining it. I love these. People are actually using these little gas stations. Oh, they actually park at the pumps. That is amazing. I love that. That is so cool. But yeah, I have a few of these gas stations kind of plopped down. It's the one thing that a lot of cities are missing, because you don't have proper gas stations in the vanilla game. So putting these down are awesome, and especially if people are using them, that's awesome as well. So yeah, these look great. We're gonna put a bunch of these around the city, and then this car repair shop is right here too. I figure having two gas stations right across this corner from each other, it's not unrealistic, but I figured I'd break it up by putting another automobile kind of thing here. And then yes, the rest of this area is just kind of food, and it's not really that populated. Like, they only have one fast food restaurant, but for now that's all they're gonna get. So yeah, I honestly don't know if I want to put anything on this side of the street, so I don't know. Maybe you guys can let me know. And then the last thing that I think I want to talk about in this episode is this right here. So this is technically, I think, called a wireless tower, and it's kind of like a cell phone tower, which is another thing that the game is missing. So I plop this down, but it's not actually doing anything. Like, our Sims don't actually have cell phones that we know about, I guess. And I really don't like that someone parked their scooter here. But anyway, I digress. This is going to actually bounce the electricity from here to here over to the toll booths, because before they didn't have electricity with that gone. Now they may have electricity because a house came up here, but yeah, it was there for purpose. And yeah, so guys, this is gonna wrap this episode up. I hope you guys liked it. Leave me a thumbs up if you did, thumbs down if you didn't like it. So you guys need to name these rivers. River A, River B, and then rename Lafayette Park over here. This whole little area up to here is the whole district. So you guys can let me know there as well in the comments. So yes, and let me know what you guys want to see next. I don't know what we're going for. I don't know what we're going to be doing in the next episode. Well, actually, I take that back. I do. We're going to be services. Doing a lot of services. We have the death care to figure out. We have the sickness. We have the funeral homes and all that kind of stuff to kind of get our heads wrapped around. I'm not sure where I'm going to put that on the map as well, but we'll get to that in the next one. So, guys, thanks for watching, and if you want, follow me on Twitter. The link is in the description. Also, if you like this series and you want to support the channel and you have a few extra dollars a month, please consider donating it to me on Patreon. That link will pop up on the screen momentarily. It helps me out tremendously, and it's going to help me actually be able to do more of this kind of content, because it does take a while to make, and hopefully it'll help me eventually upgrade the PC so we can make these kinds of cities bigger and better. So guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here in Northern Valley.